Condition claimed Mythbuster with no warning. Mythbusters was an extraordinarily successful program that aired for a total of 17 seasons before its cancellation. However, the sinister secrets surrounding Mythbusters indicate that the series may have had an additional dimension. Tori and Grant utilized social media during a chaotic moment. A majority of individuals do not consciously consider their response to an emergency until it occurs. In 2013, Grant and Tori from Mythbusters encountered this circumstance while in Los Angeles. They were waiting in a terminal when they detected gunfire and realized that an individual was attempting to murder others in the background. Instead of fleeing for safety, Grant and Tori appeared to have determined that it would be more prudent to live stream the event on social media. They were among the initial witnesses to record the incident and were subsequently subjected to police interviews due to the fatality and multiple injuries that ensued. Grant and Tori, however, were released without charges. Weapons have been Tori Belleci's specialty since he was a child. It's revealed that Tori Belleci possesses a marginal amount of experience in comparison to the other members of the Mythbusters team. Why? Tori's developed an early fondness for detonating objects and even refined his pyrotechnic abilities as a child, which qualifies him as an ideal candidate for the program. Tori subsequently admitted that if that were not enough, he had constructed his flamethrower at the tender age of 11. Although these abilities would ordinarily be sufficient to place someone on a list, years later, when he signed up for the program, they paved the way for an extraordinary career for Tori. Mythbusters disposed of every piece of evidence they discovered during the program. Have you ever contemplated the consequences of one of the Mythbusters' falsehoods being taken a step too far? It may be tempting to believe that this could never occur, but it did occur once, and it destroyed every piece of evidence before its presentation on screen. That marked only the start. In addition to expunging all traces of evidence, the individuals involved in the production were mandated to maintain strict confidentiality regarding the incident and never disclose any discoveries. The situation escalated further when the program was compelled to notify the government and involve the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, which requested Adam Savage's assistance in their scientific investigation. Tori Belleci came perilously close to detention at the age of 19. For an extended period, Tori Belleci portrayed Mythbusters and gained notoriety for his obsession with all things pyrotechnic. Nevertheless, it was this fervor that brought him perilously close to incarceration during his youth of 19 years. Tori's neighbors reported hearing gunshots, which prompted the police to be dispatched to the scene for an investigation. Fortunately, additional neighbors informed authorities that Tori had a reputation for experimenting and frequented explosives. This completely altered the situation. The authorities concluded that Tori had likely erred and no longer posed a danger to the neighborhood. As an alternative to a one-way journey to prison, Tori was issued a stern admonition to exercise greater caution when handling explosives and was released to proceed with his experiments. One fallacy is the only one that Adam Savage despises. Throughout the program, Mythbusters attempted to debunk hundreds of falsehoods, but one in particular stands out to Adam Savage for all the wrong reasons. According to the presenter, it was intended to be the one to observe their attempt to accommodate a razor blade beneath a pyramid. According to the myth, the pyramid power would maintain its sharpness better than being in the open air. Adam, however, believed that the question was whether or not magic existed, as proving otherwise would be tantamount to requesting the impossible. Adam went so far as to compare the experiment to the search for Bigfoot, stating that the creature's absence does not prove his existence, just as the precision of a razor cannot refute sorcery. The sibling of Adam Savage accused the protagonist of Mythbusters of maltreatment. An enormous turn of events befell Adam Savage in June 2020 when he was accused of child abuse against his sister. Savage had been a member of the Mythbusters cast. According to Miranda Paciana, the aforementioned incidents transpired from 1976 to 1979 and inflicted upon her enduring psychological wounds and physical problems. Six charges were submitted in court, alleging that Adam would ostensibly prevent his sister from exiting her chamber. While Adam was between 9 and 12 years old at the time, Miranda was only 7 or 10 years old when the two individuals resided in Sleepy Hollow, New York. Adam, according to court documents, transformed the circumstance into a game in which Miranda sustained lifelong and catastrophic injuries. Adam naturally held a unique perspective on the occurrences. Adam refutes any allegation of an altercation with his sister. It should not come as a surprise that Adam Savage refuted every single allegation. His attorney, Adam B. Brettler, issued the following statement. "For many years, she has persistently and unjustly attacked me. The passage further states that Adam desires the assistance my sister requires to achieve peace. He did not have his thoughts to himself. Adam asserts that Miranda has severed all ties with her loved ones and tortured our entire family. His relatives? According to Karen, the mother of Adam, her daughter Miranda's suffering was devastating because she suffers from severe mental challenges and caused everyone's despair. Miranda maintains her position that her statements are accurate, but adds that she is receiving assistance to recover from the alleged abuse. A single detonation was of such magnitude that it caused a profound shaking throughout the community." Undoubtedly, MythBusters featured an abundance of detonations, with a portion of the audience tuned in weekly to observe what will be blasted upon next. Regrettably, it appears that single detonation deviated slightly from its intended course, causing seismic activity in a nearby municipality. Local authorities were present if something went awry, but they refrained from disclosing the plan to the local populace. Already a popular program, they were concerned that a large audience would congregate to watch MythBusters. The group was curious as to whether or not they could deflate a mannequin's hosiery. In the end, they caused tremors throughout the neighborhood and even threw a woman from her sofa. While no one sustained injuries, everyone did suspect that a horrific incident had occurred. An arrest was made against a college student in Florida for imitating MythBusters. They assert that we should leave matters to the professionals for a variety of reasons. An unfortunate Florida college student missed that communication while attempting to replicate an item he had observed on the program. Christian Barnes Duke constructed an at-home incendiary device and intended to try it in his dormitory stairwell. The police were curious as to what motivated Christian to attempt a do-it-yourself project, and he admitted that he had witnessed a similar item on MythBusters. Subsequently, his attorney contended that Christian intended to experiment without causing any damage to others. Despite this, the student was detained for several hours of interrogation to ascertain his lack of threat to students. Originally, MythBusters was conceived as an entirely distinct program. Could it be that MythBusters was originally envisioned as an entirely distinct program? True, it was intended to be more consistent with the program's name, given that the presenter's original intention was to explore verifiable falsehoods and urban legends. They soon realized, however, that there was a finite number of beliefs that they might run out of concepts to include on the show. Not for that reason alone did they opt to alter the series. MythBusters rapidly realized that episodes based on movie sequences and whether or not the host would always evade peril were immensely popular with viewers. The finest part? Social media's inexhaustible supply of films and videos ensured that the crew had an ample amount of material to incorporate into each episode. The majority of MythBusters' cast had prior film experience. It should come as no surprise that a significant number of MythBusters' cast members previously worked on film sets. Jamie Heineman is among the many, having owned the special effects company M5 Industries, which contributed to films including the action Top Gun and the science fiction Matrix sequels. Adam Savage contributed to The Matrix, albeit in the capacity of a model creator rather than a maestro of special effects. Adam has additionally contributed to the science fiction films Galaxy Man and Bicentennial Man. Surprisingly, the science fiction Star Wars franchise is what unites so many members of the group, including Jamie Heineman, Tori Belleci, and Grant Imahara, who have all appeared in the films. Initially, the program was rejected in favor of another endeavor. It's come a long way since MythBusters was initially proposed to the Discovery Channel so many years ago. Initially, its intended title was Tall Tales or Truth, and there was more to the distinction than that. The concept was conceived in 2002 by Peter Reese, an Australian producer and writer, but there was an issue. It was discovered that the network was opposed to giving the go-ahead for two similar concepts because it was already developing a similar program. They advised Peter that they might contemplate investing in his venture, contingent upon certain modifications he implemented. After promptly soliciting Jamie Hyneman's assistance on three pilot episodes, he concluded that Jamie alone befitted the role of one of the presenters. MythBusters fired a firearm into a residence by accident. An additional misconception debunked on MythBusters pertained to cannonballs. The group then proceeded to the Dullen Range in Alameda County, where they attempted to test their theory by launching a projectile. Nevertheless, they managed to evade the intended target and nearly claimed a significant number of lives before the projectile ultimately stopped. Unbeknownst to them, the projectile traveled 700 yards before being stopped after passing through the roof of another residence, slicing through the window of a minivan, and passing through a dozing couple's residence. To add insult to injury, the projectile was traveling at bullet speed. Thankfully, nobody was injured during the experiment that went awry. An individual declined a breathalyzer following his viewing of a MythBusters episode. In 2012, Dustin Carpenter's circumstances changed after he viewed an episode of MythBusters. Officers observed Dustin while he was traveling in Fort Pierce, Florida, and they suspected something was amiss with the individual. They approached him intending to conduct a breathalyzer test while he was reportedly laboring to stand with bloodshot eyes. "The issue is, I've already seen it on MythBusters," Dustin declined. Dustin claimed to have watched an episode of the program in which it was demonstrated that a breathalyzer test could not be beaten, and he was concerned that he would fail. Unfortunately, claiming to have seen something on MythBusters does not suffice as a valid defense for driving under the influence. Dustin was arrested and taken to prison. Barack Obama intended to pique children's interest in science through MythBusters. Even the most devoted MythBusters fans may be unaware that in one episode of the show, former President Barack Obama made a jest about Jamie and Adam neglecting to test a solar ray to its fullest extent. The device in question was established in the 2nd century, and its operation remained largely unknown. Obama, who desired to use his name on the program to encourage more children to pursue careers in science while in the White House, deemed that insufficient. Although some individuals regarded it as borderline irrational science, the presenters proceeded with a re-execution of the experiment, which once more proved unsuccessful. However, their strategy was successful. Years passed with an error in the introductory credits. It's noteworthy that the introductory credits of MythBusters contained an error that persisted for an astounding 4 seasons before it was rectified by an audience member. It was discovered that the formula used to calculate the area of a circle was inaccurate, as it stated that the correct equation was 2 times pi times the radius squared. Nevertheless, this is how the circumference of a circle is determined. To calculate the area, one would need to multiply pi by the square of the radius of the circle. Even though it may seem like a trivial oversight, many individuals were astounded when they realized the error, particularly considering their familiarity with Jamie and Adam at that juncture.